Hi everybody, it's Professor Finley and my teaching assistant Gidget, and we are here today to give you a great workout. We're going to start with a nice rigorous cardio, heart pumping, raise the core body temperature workout. Then we'll progress into a nice Pilates session where we really get to those major muscle groups that we've been working so hard on, and we're going to finish today with a nice easy stretch to just work out the tight spots. All right, so everyone get on your mat, feet parallel, pull your shoulders back, engage those deep core stabilizers, and we'll get started. Here we go, starting off with just a nice light jog in place. Barely lifting those feet from your mat. Just really focusing on the landing, the toe ball heel articulation into the floor. Swinging those elbows, getting the upper body involved. And once again, maintaining our beautiful posture that we've worked so hard on. Collarbones open, shoulders back, rib cage stable, core stabilized. Good guys, we're in it to win it today. Gotta keep those hearts and lungs strong. One more set. Let's pick it up. A little bit higher with those knees now. A little more swing to those elbows. Keep breathing deeply. Inhale deeply, exhale deeply. There, we're getting ready to bring it up a notch again. Just a little bit faster now. Involve the arms a little bit more now. Bring those knees up just a little higher. Okay, we're gonna take it up into a run in place. Really intensify. Good. Just kind of tap it out for me, guys. Side to side, we're gonna make a small change now. We're gonna go into some high knee marches. Really getting those arms swinging. Here we go, knees. And two, and three, and four, good, good. Five, and six, and seven. Still holding your upper backs, maintaining your posture, feeling your core. These are a little harder to maintain stability. We're on one leg for just a little bit longer. Good, we're about ready to make a small change, guys. Let's bring the heel of our hand to the inside of our knee. We get a little bit of spinal rotation this way. Keep those arms nice and big. Continue to bring those knees up nice and high. Chest is open, ribs are stable. Another small change, let's do elbow. Good, involving the upper body a little more now. Starting to wake up those obliques. Another small change. Let's take some butt kicks. Okay, I'm using a flexed heel to kick myself in the butt. Big swinging arms, but still very stable through the upper body. Good, let's keep that going, guys. One more set. Good. Guys, just tap it out. We're gonna go into some lunges next. I just want everyone to keep moving. Keep the heart rate going. Let's step it out to parallel, about shoulder distance apart, knees and toes pointed forwards, really maintaining neutral as we take it into our lunge. And two, and three, and four. Keep the knees behind the toes. Five, long spine as you lunge, six, and seven, and eight, small change, squat, pulse, rise, squat, pulse, rise, squat, pulse, rise, nice and deep, pulse up to the balls of the feet,
pulse, run. You can also take that as the rise as a small jump. And squat, pulse, rise, and squat, pulse, rise. Back into your squat position. Let's just pulse. And pulse. Are you maintaining your posture? Do you feel your core working? Let's take another set. Last set. Good, I'm feeling another set of squat, pulse, rise. And we squat, pulse, rise. And we squat, pulse, rise. And good, and rise four more. Nice long tailbone. Reach those sit bones each time. Let's take two more. Really starting to get those thigh muscles warmed up. And one more. Come back into your squat, guys. Let's pulse it out. Starting to get that heart rate up. My cat's not doing a very good job of assisting right now. Oh, these are feeling good, guys. Feel a little bit of that burn. Good, guys. Come up. Tap it out. Keep moving. Just keep moving. Good, guys. Let's face sideways on our mats. Take your leg that's closest to your screen and go into a step back lunge. And switch. And three. And four. You can go deep as your body can handle. Five. And six. And seven. Here comes a small change. So we're going to lunge, pulse, come up and balance. Lunge, pulse, balance. Two more. Lunge, pulse, balance. One more. Lunge, pulse, balance. Step back with your foot that's furthest from your screen. And switch. And three. And four. And we'll go five. And six. And seven. And eight. Into our pattern. Lunge, pulse, balance. And lunge, pulse, balance. And lunge, pulse, balance. One more. And balance. Good, guys. Tap it out. Five, six, seven, eight. Let's go into our marked jumping jacks. Long leg and long arms. Good, let's keep those going. Six, and seven, and eight. One more, and then I think it's time for some actual jumping jacks. Keep breathing, guys. Think about your centers. Good. And just keep these going. Looking good, guys. Let's do eight more. Seven, six, and five, four. We'll go three, and two, and one. Good, guys, tap it out. We're gonna go into some of our curtsy squats. Ready, and here we go. Step, press, two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. Let's circle those arms. Circle, and two, and three, and four, and we'll go five, and six, and seven, and eight. Let's get our upper bodies involved just a little more, guys. Sideways on your mat, come towards this end. Nod your chin, roll it through. Hands to your mat, walk it out into your push-up or plank position. Two push-ups today. One, two. Walk back towards your feet. Soften your knees. Roll your backs up. Nod your chin. Roll your spines down. Hands to your mat. Walk it out. Find your plank. Reach those heels away from the crown of the head. Walk back towards your feet. Soften your knees. Roll your spine up. Nod your chin. Roll down. soften our knees. And we're going to do one more for good measure today, guys. Planking is so good for us. We know that. Not always easy to make yourself do it. Find that plank. Lift those belly button muscles. One, two. Walk it back. Soften your knees. Roll your spines up. Turn to face your screen. Feet parallel. Let's circle the arms up and back. And two. Nice and big now. Three. And four. And forward now. And two. And three. And four. Circle them back once again. Go as big as you can. Two. And three. And four. Circle them forward now. And two. And three. And four. Take a nice big inhale, guys. Go deep, go big. Exhale, press it all the way back out. Great job, guys. Let's come down to our mats. Find your flex band. And we'll go straight away into a nice little Pilates session. We're going to start off sitting on our flex bands as we've done the last couple of sessions, right? And just starting by getting into our nice, neutral, comfortable sitting position. So that means being right on top of our sits bones with a beautiful, elongated, neutral spine. Arms just nice and heavy down by your sides. Let's take a moment to just close our eyes. Breathe naturally. And tune out the outside world and tune into our bodies. We're going to start with some of our deep breathing today. Let's all take a nice big inhale breath through the nose. And begin by just simply pressing that air down as deep into the base of your lungs as you possibly can, getting that sense of weight and heaviness and expansion. And we're going to hold that breath at the top today for five. Try to make it a little bit bigger. Four, three, two, one. And then I want you to completely exhale all of that air back out through your mouth. Just a very complete exhale breath. Inhale once again through your nose. If you can, go a little bit deeper this time. Really take that air in, and we hold it at the top for five, four, three, two, one. Completely exhale all of that air back out through your mouth, all the way, every ounce out of your lungs. Into our diaphragmatic belly breath this time, in through your nose. Press the air down deep into the base of your lungs and let your belly muscles stretch and expand and open with your air. Hold this breath at the top for five, four, three, two, one, and then press it all the way back out. Really deflate that belly, everybody, and press the abdominal wall flat towards your spine. Another big inhale breath through the nose. Big belly breath, really push the abdominal wall outwards, feed every cell of your body with that oxygen. Hold it at the top for five, four, three, two, one, and then exhale, press it out, really deflate everybody, press that abdominal wall nice and flat. And then we hold it there as we take our next big inhale breath into the sides and back of the rib cage this time. Really opening and stretching the muscles in between each and every rib. Hold this breath at the top for five, four, three, two, one. And then out through that imaginary straw, starting to narrow the waist in from all sides, from all angles. And we'll take that nice lateral breath again in through the nose. Make this one just a little bit bigger and hold it for five, four, three, two, one. And then out through those pursed lips, really go big. Take all of that air back out. Shrink the waist and lift slightly through the pelvic floor. Good, guys. Take another inhale breath through the nose. And this time as you exhale, find the transversus in the pelvic floor and nod your chin towards your collarbone and round the back of your head, your neck, and your upper thoracic spine, over your leg position. Take another inhale breath in this position and feel the upper back stretch and open with your breath. And then through those pursed lips, exhale, press it back out. Inhale, breath, even bigger this time. Really open up the upper back. Feel the scapula separate around the back of the rib cage. And then exhale, one link at a time, one vertebrae at a time. Roll and stack your spine until you're sitting just a little bit taller, a little bit straighter than you were when we started. And go ahead and open those eyes. Take an inhale breath, tilt your head over to the right. Exhale breath, a slow neck head roll all the way around. Inhale, add the shoulders. Exhale, take the shoulders all the way around. Inhale, add the waist, the rib cage, the shoulders, the neck and the head will come all the way around. And then we're gonna flex forward and roll and stack the spine. Take an inhale breath, head goes to the left now. Exhale breath, send it all the way around. Remember, gentle and heavy. That's our rule, gentle and heavy. Add those shoulders and take them around. Bending from the waist now, taking the rib cage, the shoulders, the neck, and the head all the way around. And then we flex forward. And then we roll and stack. Take an inhale breath, send those shoulders up. Exhale, roll them back down and forward. Couple more. Just keep breathing as you circle the shoulders. And let's take two more. And this will be our last one. We're gonna go in the opposite direction, guys. Let's take those shoulders up and roll them forward and down and back. And two. And three. And four. Good job, you guys. Go ahead now and reach for the ends of your band. One on each side. Open those arms. It's about a 45 degree angle from your torso. Take an inhale breath to prepare. As you exhale, find the transversus abdominis and the pelvic floor and sweep those arms up. And then as you inhale, squeeze those elbows towards each other right behind your back. And we'll do a few more, just a little bit of upward and then downward rotation. Imagine the scapula behind you, just kind of gliding around the back of the rib cage, just very smoothly. No winging, no tilting, just smooth around the back of the rib cage. As the front of the rib cage stays gently closed, very stable. Okay. We're keeping the shoulders pressed gently down as we send the arms up, and we're making sure that we don't go into too much scapular depression when we squeeze those elbows towards each other. Let's take three more today. Get those deltoid muscles working. And two more. Good. And one more. And release. Release your left hand. Bring it to your knee or to the side of your thigh. And reaching. Let's take an inhale breath here and an exhale breath to go into lateral flexion. And inhale and exhale. Inhaling, exhaling, inhaling and exhaling. Reaching, really feeling that stretch. Good. And pull the elbow back and we'll take one more. Really go up through the sides of the rib cage and return. Let's just switch sides. I'm actually using my opposite hand for a little bit of leverage so I can get that nice big lateral flexion. Let's take an inhale breath, circle that arm up. Exhale, feel that stretch. Inhale and exhale. So a few more, let's keep that breath pattern going. Good, really feel that side of the rib cage open. Kind of like a fan, reaching, opening through the side of the rib cage. Good, and we're also getting those obliques firing, which is really nice. Good, and return. Beautifully done, guys. Come off your band.
directly into our external rotation of the humerus and the shoulder girdle. We know this one. And coming out the index finger, thumb. We'll take an inhale to prep and an exhale to pull that band apart. Sending those fists away from each other, but really not splaying or opening the front of the rib cage. Right? The band coming around the rib cage serves as a good reminder that we're not compressing the ribs, we're just keeping them gently closed as we open those fists. We really want to make this about the muscles of the shoulder girdle and the upper back. Definitely the rhomboids and the mid traps, those important postural muscles. At the same time, we're giving the muscles of the chest, the pectoral muscles most specifically, that nice opening stretch. We'll take three more today. And two more. And this will be our last one. Directly into flexion and extension, ends coming out the index finger, thumbs. We take our inhale nice and big. Exhale to flex the spine forward. Inhale to extend it to the back, releasing those arms. Exhaling and inhaling. Let's take a few more, guys. Just kind of going right into things today. We've all had this warm up enough times to really know what we need to be focusing on and what we're doing. So we'll make it just a little more continuous. And three more. Nice big opening of the chest. Really support the back of the head and the neck. And two more. Good, everybody. And one more. Good. And return. Bring the band around to the front of the body. Hold it up above the head, just slightly forward of your forehead. Nice and tall in those sits bones still. And back into lateral flexion just because it feels so good. Inhale. Exhale to reach that right fist down and pull that left fist up. And return, and two. Remember, we're going up through the side of the rib cage as much as we're pulling down through the opposite side. Let's let that band pass behind the head for a couple, right behind the head. You have to think a little more about the rib cage with this option, but it does feel good. It's nice and opening. And one more over to the right, and one more over to the left. Good, just pull those fists apart. And release, just strengthening the upper back. Good, rib cage still stable. Let's take three more. Put some determination into it. Two more. And one more. Pull the band forward into spinal rotation. Inhale. And exhale to rotate. Inhale to return. Feel like you're spiraling upwards each time. Feel the opposition in the upper back and the arms. Make sure you're spiraling just right around that midline of your body, guys, like you have a maypole right down the center of the crown of the head. Good, and we'll take reach. Do one more in each direction. Really get those obliques firing today. And one more. And then we'll pull the band open. And as we pull the band open, we're keeping the rib cage stable. Good. Just right below the sternum each time, guys, not too high. Slightly lower than shoulder height. Two more. And one more. And release. Band across our laps, guys. Side on our mats. Beautiful Pilates stance. Don't let those knees collapse in on each other. Hold on to that sit bone distance apart. Draw yourselves up on your sit bones. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, spin the pelvis back. Walk the hands along the back of your thigh. Really create that posterior pelvic tilt. Roll through your imprint and then all the way through your spine. Walk your heels in towards your sits bones. Relax your arms down by your sides, palms facing down. Quick body scan. Heaviness through the back of the head, a majority of the weight right behind the bridge of our noses. Scan down to the back of your neck. Make sure you're noticing a little bit of cervical extension. Scan down to your thoracic spine and the back of your rib cage. This is the one I often find that I have to adjust, right? And make sure you're feeling that sense of heaviness, especially towards the bottom third of the rib cage, thoracic spine. Bring your awareness down to your lumbar spine now. Make sure you're noticing that little bit of spinal extension, not too much. Should be about right underneath your belly button. Bring your awareness now to the back of your sacrum and your coccyx. Feel that sense of weight and heaviness, right? Arms are down by your sides without any tension or gripping. Your collarbones, your shoulders, and your upper backs are beautifully open. And of course, as always, the front of the ribcage just gently heavy. No compression. Take an inhale breath and just really enjoy the feeling of being in a really beautifully neutral spine position. And then an exhale breath through that imaginary straw and really draw in on the transversus abdominis. Feel that contraction and that slight lift to the pelvic floor. Let's take that one more time today. Inhale, just let it release. Exhale, gather the waist in. Feel that contraction, lift through the pelvic floor. Let's go on to a little bit more of our tabletop work. Take an inhale breath. As you exhale, feel that gentle contraction and peel your right foot up to tabletop. And then exhale, inhale, release it. Exhale, left foot up to tabletop and release. Just little marches. And right, release, and left, release. One more each leg. Right, release, and left. Release. Little modification. You're going to take the right leg out now and you're going to lengthen and hover it and bring it back. And then left leg, lengthen and hover it right off your mat and bring it back. And right. And in. And left. And in. Pointing the toe as you reach. Bring it in. One more time. Left. Bring it in. Now we're going to do a little pattern. We're going to lift the right leg up to tabletop. Lengthen it to hover. Bring it back to tabletop and place it on your mat. Left side, tabletop, extend, and tabletop, return. Right, extend, tabletop. This is subtle work, guys, but so important. Left, extend, bring it back, return. Two more sets each leg, and return. Left, lengthen, and return. We're working those really fine-tuned muscles. Deepen the spine. And left leg one more time. Important exercises, those really subtle ones. Now we'll get a little bit harder. Take an inhale breath. As you exhale, contract your abdominals now and press into your imprint. Inhale, feel those lumbar vertebrae connect to your mat. And then exhale, release. Inhale, exhale, once again, contract your abdominals, press into imprint, squeeze your glutes. Inhale, peel your right foot up to tabletop, exhale breath, maintaining your imprint, peel your left foot up to tabletop. Today, we're going to flip our palms to face upwards, and we're going to open our arms slightly. Think about the letter A, kind of an A shape away from your body. Into spine twist supine, more challenging modification today. Inhale, maintain your imprint. Backs of the shoulders press firmly into your mat. Take your knees over to the right to the 2 o'clock mark. Exhale, bring your knees straight up. Inhale, maintain that imprint. Take your legs over to the left to the 10 o'clock mark. And up, we keep going, guys, keep breathing. Inhaling, finding your imprint at the top as you exhale. Inhaling and exhaling. So I've taken away a little bit of that arm support today and bring them up, relying a little bit more on the obliques and the deep core stabilizers. Right, and then over to the right and up and over to the left. A couple more each side, a little bit deeper, guys. Challenge yourselves. Over to the right, just a little bit beyond where that point of comfort is, and then bring them up. And then over to the left. Keep those shoulders strong, guys. Feel your upper backs. And up. One more time each side. And up. Really feel imprint every time, especially as you bring those knees up. And feel your imprint. Flip your palms over, guys. Palms are facing down. Draw them in by your hips. Take an inhale breath. Lower your right foot, toe, ball, heel. Exhale, left foot, toe, ball, heel. Come back to your Pilates stance and find your neutral spine position. Once again, take your inhale breath. As you exhale, contract your abdominals, come into imprint, squeeze your glutes. We're going into pelvic curl, up into our bridge position.
inhale at the top of your bridge. Make sure your ribs are heavy and your hips are high. And then exhale, articulate back down. Let's do a few more just like that. Inhaling and exhaling to roll up. Inhale at the top. Exhale to articulate down. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. One more time, just like that, guys. Inhale and we exhale. Inhale, create that long line and exhale. Go ahead and bring your right leg to tabletop. Laterally rotate it and place the outside of your right ankle right across your left knee. We're going into lateral rotation, and I really want you to maximize the lateral rotation of that right leg, but I don't want you to start to roll or curl that left hip up off your mat. Inhale, exhale, abdominals, and then put a lot of thought into that left glute today. A lot of thought into it. And then roll up to bridge. Inhale. Exhale, roll back down. The lateral rotation, let's just keep going as I talk to you, of that right leg is going to make it a little harder to stabilize. You're going to feel maybe a little bit more of that rocking or rotating sensation. A couple more. Inhale, exhale. Make sure you feel that glute each time. Inhale at the top. Exhale, roll back down. Inhale. Exhale, roll to the top. Nice open collarbones, closed ribs, and then exhale to roll back down. We're gonna do a couple more, and we're gonna hold the top this time, guys. Inhale, exhale, abdominals, glute, especially that left glute, roll up. Inhale continuously for a count of 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale to roll back down. One more set, just like that. Inhale. Exhale, abdominals, strong glutes, roll up. Continuous inhale at the top for 4, 3, 2, 1, and an exhale to roll back down. Release that right foot back to your mat, guys. Left leg up to tabletop, laterally rotate it. Send the outside of the left ankle right across the front of your right knee. Lots of lateral rotation, lots of turnout in that left leg. You do want to kind of challenge yourselves. Inhale, starting slow. Exhale, I feel the glute on that right side contract, and I roll up to my bridge position, making sure the backs of my shoulders are feeling nice and strong, and then I roll back down. Keep breathing, inhale. Don't forget the glutes. Really high hips at the top, and roll back down. We'll do a couple more, inhaling and exhaling. As you inhale, try to perfect the position. And then exhale. You guys know all the rules. One more slow. Inhale. Focus on technique. Exhale. Inhale. Focus on position. And exhale to roll down with a hold at the top. Inhale. Exhale. Don't forget about those glutes each time. Continuous inhale for 4, 3. Feel the stability. 2, 1. Exhale to roll back down. One more set. Inhale. Exhale. Don't forget that glute. Feel that contraction. Inhale at the top. Good. 3, 4. And roll back down and release that left foot back to your mat, guys. Make sure you're back into that beautiful Pilates stance. Let's take an inhale breath and create that cervical cranial flexion. And then stare straight up to the ceiling. Again, inhale, nod your chin. Don't forget to lower your eyes towards your belly buttons. And then come back. Let's go into low curl this time. Inhale, nod your chin. Exhale, roll up to that low curl position. Inhale, chest a little higher. And then exhale, roll back down. Couple more. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling to reach the fingertips. Exhale to roll down. Small change this time. Inhale. And exhale, inhale to sweep the arms out and back. Exhale to roll down. We do a very quick elbow check, and then we go into a set of 15 today, guys. Here we go. Inhale to prepare. And we go 1 and 2. Feel the strength each time, guys. 3 and 4. Try to come up a little higher now. 5 and 6 and 7. And 8 and 9 and 10. Do a little elbow check. 1, and two, and three. Make sure you're coming up as high as you can, still maintaining neutral. Two more, and one more. Roll all the way back down. Okay, guys, bring your hands from behind your head. We're gonna do a little bit of this, what we would call kind of alternative Pilates reformer work. We did this last week. Several of you mentioned that you kind of liked this work a little bit, so I figured we'd continue with it. So we're gonna start with our feet completely together and our knees completely together. The ends of my band are coming out the index finger thumb side, so there's no kind of twisting of your wrists, and you're gonna ping your elbows right down by your sides, either side of your rib cage. Okay, neutral spine position for this one. Knees together, feet together. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, just simply press the feet out and return. Make sure you've really got the balls of the feet and toes securely in that band. Two, return, and three. So as you press those legs out, you might be noticing it's a little harder to hold on to that neutral spine position. The back kind of wants to arch. So I am actually challenging those abdominal muscles. And let's take four more. And three more. And two more. And exhale breath, one more. Good, nod the chin, come up to a low curl position, continue, one. And two, still neutral spine. Three, elbows are hovering off your mat. And four. And four more, and three more, and two more, and one more. Come back to tabletop, roll back down. Let's see if we can do heels together, toes apart. For my dancers, it's gonna feel like a little baby first position, right? If you look at your feet, you should be seeing a narrow V position. Neutral spine, elbows pinned. Take your inhale breath. Exhale, push the balls of the feet out. Release, and two, and three, and four. Really feel the glutes and hamstrings push. Five, and six, and seven, and eight. Nod your chin and roll up, and we continue. One, and two, hovering those elbows, and three, and four, and five, and six, and seven, and eight. Roll all the way back down, guys. Release your left foot out of the band. Bring it to your kind of like half of a Pilates stance. Bring your working leg, or the leg that's in the band, back to parallel. Ball of the foot securely in the band, elbows pinned to your mat. A little bit of one leg work. We're gonna push out and in, and two, a little bit harder now, three, and four, and let's go five, really push through the back of the leg, guys, six, and seven, and eight, nod the chin, roll up, and one, and two, elbows again hovering, and three, and four. Starting to feel it in my calves a little bit now. Feels good. Five, and six, and seven, and eight. Roll all the way back down, guys. Before you take the right foot out, place the ball of the left foot into your band and then release your right. Bring it back to tabletop and pin the elbows again. And we go one, and two, and three, and four, and we'll go five, and six, seven, eight. Nod your chin, curl up, hover those elbows, one, and two, and three, four, feeling the strength, five, and six, nice and strong, seven, and eight. Come back in. Oh, that gives you a lot of bang for your buck, doesn't it? It's a good one. Okay, band off to the sides. Good, just give those hands. That was a lot of hand and fist work as well. A little bit of bicep work. Get a lot out of that one. Take a couple of nice deep breaths. And then we're gonna roll over and we're going to our back extension work. We are gonna use our band for this one. So go ahead and take your band.
place it towards the top of your mat. Just kind of relatively evenly spaced. Doesn't have to be perfect. Just have to be able to reach for it. Okay. And let's come into our prone position for some back extension prone. So we're going to start this one just as we normally do. My arms are in the goalpost position, right? I'm feeling my co-contraction, a little bit of activity through the glutes and hamstrings. Forehead on my mat, a little bit of downward pressure through my palms and through my forearms to create some energy in the upper back position. Take an inhale breath. As you exhale, I want everybody to lengthen just a little bit more. Put a little bit more downward pressure through the arms and palms and come up into extension. Let's all inhale at the top and exhale to articulate back down. Just a few more, guys. Here we go. Inhale, exhale to lengthen and press up. Inhale, we're making sure we're not overusing the back of the neck. Exhale to articulate back down. Inhale. Exhale, really reach the toes away from the crown of the head to come up. Inhale at the top. Exhale to roll back down. Inhale, this is gonna be our last one slow today, guys. And reach, really open up the chest, open up the sternum, and roll back down. And then lengthen your arms down by your sides. We're gonna go right into our consecutive faster ones. Lengthening to inhale. Up, exhaling to articulate down. Really reaching those fingers. We're feeling just a little bit of scapular retraction every time. Good, and let's take four more. And three more. Nice open collarbones, two more. Reaching those fingertips, one more. Come forward, reach your hands forward for your band. And then pull and extend those arms out in front of you. You should feel like the letter Y. Right? Those arms are creating a V position. My fists are palms down into the floor, forehead on the mat. We're still coming up into back extension, guys. Higher than hover spine. Take your inhale breath. As you exhale, lengthen first, and then start to come up into extension, letting the band pass right behind your head, right behind your upper back, and then finally release behind you. And then let it skim right across your upper back and the back of your head to come back. And two, and release. Each time you try to come up, guys, pull your fists apart from each other as the band skims your upper back, and then it releases behind you. And then your fists open powerfully as you come back to your Y position. And then pull those fists apart and come up. And then pull them apart again to return. Couple more, guys. Reach and up. Reach. And return. One more like that. Pull that band apart and come up. Pull that band apart and return. Adding a challenge. Pull the band apart. Come all the way up. Stay there with an inhale breath. Exhale. Pull the band apart. Little pulses for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 more, 2 more. One more. Let it skim right across your back and the back of your head to return. One more set like that, guys. Inhale. Big exhale breath. Run along the back of your head. Upper back, and then it releases, and then you pull on. One, two. Feel the strength. Three, four, five, six. Keep breathing. Seven, eight, nine, ten. Let it skim your upper back and the back of your head, and then just let it release, guys. Good. Bring your arms back to the goalpost position for me. And we're going to go into hover spine. A little different modification today. Forehead's resting on your mat, feeling your co-contraction. Upper back, however, should be relaxed right now. A little bit of scapular protraction because we're going into hover spine. Take an inhale breath. As you exhale, retract your scapula and start lifting the backs of your hands and your forearms and your elbows towards the ceiling. As you come into hover spine, inhale, hold, exhale, let everything float back down and let the upper back release. Inhale, exhale, scapular retraction. Lift the backs of the hands, the forearms, and the elbows up. Inhale, don't try to get higher, but try to lift your elbows a little bit higher and then float back down. So we're lifting the elbows higher, but we're not lifting the body higher. Inhale, exhale, scapular retraction. Pull the elbows and the backs of the hands and arms up away from your mat. Inhale, try to lift the backs of the arms just a little bit higher. Exhale, float back down.
One more time, guys. Inhale. Exhale, retract the scapula. Here goes those elbows and the backs of the hands. They're reaching just a little bit higher. And now I want you to cross the fingers right in front of your forehead and float all the way back down. Open your legs a little bit wider than your mat. Laterally rotate your legs and bring your heels together. Let's go into heel squeeze. Guys, let's do a set of four heel squeeze, just legs, glutes and legs, ooh, heavy glutes. And let us add hover spine for a set of four. So you know what's coming at you today. All right, you can just focus on my voice. You don't have to look. All right, feel your core contraction. Press the front of your pelvis down. That's the kind of starting point. It's important to start this one correctly. Take an inhale breath. As you exhale, increase the downward pressure through the front of the pelvis. So squeeze your glutes, squeeze your heels, and lift your thighs off your mat. Inhale and exhale to release. Again, inhale. Exhale, make sure you're using those glutes each time, squeezing those heels. Inhale to lift, exhale to lower. Inhale, exhale, glutes, squeeze those heels, lift those thighs. Inhale, exhale, make sure you're feeling your core contraction, guys. Inhale, and exhale, squeeze and lift. Inhale at the top. Exhale, float back down, adding hover spine. Here we go, inhale. Exhale, squeeze those glutes, lift the thighs, and slightly lift the chest and face off. Inhale at the top, exhale to float back down. Inhale, exhale, glutes, heels, and hover spine. Inhale, and exhale. We only have two more, guys. We can do this. Inhale, make them count. Exhale, inhale, and exhale. Let's do one more, guys. Inhale. Really breathe it out, really breathe in, and then exhale to release. Good, guys, lengthen your legs behind you, bring your legs together, slide your hands to your shoulders, and walk yourselves back into shell stretch. That was a nice upper back series today, guys. I'm feeling it in those spinal muscles, but we know we all need that right now. Take your inhale breath, stretch those spine muscles, and then exhale, roll and stack your spines. Okay, guys, you guessed it. We're going right away into the 100, okay? Let's just do classic 100 today. Knees together, feet together, okay? Roll into your supine position. Choose your options. If you're choosing Pilates stance, let's go ahead and separate the legs and feet to a sit bone distance. But if you're choosing one of the tabletop or extended versions, let's bring the knees and feet together today. All right, I think that'll be a nice option. Okay, choose your options. When we come back in, guys, a set of 10 chest lift high curl at the end. Okay, set yourself up, imprint your spine, legs up to tabletop if that's what you're choosing. Okay, lengthen those necks, earlobes away from shoulders. Take a beautifully big inhale breath. Let's oxygenate those bodies. Exhale breath, drop your eyes, drop your chins, and come into your high curl position. Arms clean and strong, and here we go. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, breathe out, 2, 3, 4, 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 20. 30. 40, in, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 50. How we doing? 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 60. Belly button down, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 70. Easy next, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 80. In, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 90. Shoulders nice and lifted, 2, 3, 4, 5, and out, 2, 3, 4, 100. Back to tabletop, stay in it with me, guys. One, and a really small release. Two, barely release. Three, the emphasis is on getting up higher. Four, even higher. Five, really feel that belly button sink. Six, and seven, and eight. Reach those fingertips. Nine, here's our last one, guys, we made it. 10, roll all the way back. Hug those knees in towards your torso. Rock side to side. Sometimes it just feels good to work that way. All right, guys, we're gonna go right away into classic shoulder bridge. We haven't done this for a couple of sessions. I thought this would be a good one today. So we're going to do a 7 kick shoulder bridge. And then I'm going to call out some arm options. And then I'm going to add a little modification at the end. I don't need to show it. I'm just going to show, give you guys some heel raises in bridge position, which I think you're going to like. All right? Sit bone distance apart. Remember, this is done completely in neutral spine. No pelvic curl to get up into this one. Take a nice big inhale breath. Our bodies are going to need that oxygen. Exhale, shrink the transversus abdominis, lift the pelvic floor, squeeze the glutes, and just come right up into your bridge position. Start off by feeling the backs of the arms and the hands pressing down. Inhale, my right leg extends through tabletop and all the way up to the ceiling. Here we go. Exhale and inhale, and two, and three, four, and five, and six, and seven. Back through tabletop, toe ball heel, down through the right foot, up with the left leg. And we go one, hips nice and lifted, two, ribcage calm, three, and four. Feel the backs of your shoulders, guys. Five, and six, and seven. Back through tabletop, toe ball heel, option to bend those elbows and send those fingertips up, down through the left, release the right. One, and two, backs of the shoulders so strong, three, keep those hips up, four, and five, and six, and seven, right leg to tabletop, toe ball heel, down through the right, release the left. One, keep breathing, guys, two, we exhale and inhale, good, five, and six, and seven, through tabletop, toe ball heel, option to completely extend the arms, down through the left, release the right. One, oh, so challenging. Two, feel the backs of the shoulders, guys. Three, and four, and five. Ooh, my hamstrings are firing. Six, and seven, through tabletop, toe ball heel, down through the right, release the left. We're getting so close, guys. One, and two, feel the strength in the core. Three, and four, nice high hips. Five, and six, and seven, through tabletop, toe ball heel. Bring the arms down if you chose to bring them up, okay? Feet sit bone distance apart. I want everyone to lift their heels and lower their heels. Keep those hips high the whole time, lifting and lowering. As you lift, I want you to place the weight on the big toe, second toe side of the ball of each foot. Lifting and releasing. Lifting and releasing. Really maintain that bridge position, guys. Just a few more, I promise. And let's take five and four and three and two. Feel that bridge. One more. Place the heels down. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, set those hips down. Everybody roll towards your screens and come all the way back up. That one is so good. All right, and that last exercise works a muscle. You have two layers of calf muscle. You have your gastrocnemius on the top and you have your soleus beneath that. And because of the bent leg position, as we lift and lower those heels, we're really strengthening and activating that second level, or that layer of calf muscle underneath the soleus. So good. All right, guys, we're gonna go on to just a little bit of our sideline work. So we're gonna go on to clam today, sideline clamshells. So go ahead and grab your flex band. We've done this before. Kind of come into a Pilates stance position. You can go closer or further apart, depending on how hard you wanna work out today and on the strength of your flex band or your resistance band, all right? And we've learned how to tie that bow because we know it's easier to release the bow at the end when we want to bring it back to just being a straightforward band, okay? So I'm going to choose kind of a medium resistance right now. I'm going to bring the band just right to the crease of my knees, which is where it kind of works best for me. You may be a little bit different, okay? And we're going to get into a side lying position. So we know that we want the neutral spine to kind of line up with that back edge of our mats, right? Nice long sets of tailbone and sits bones. We don't want to tuck them under. We kind of want to release them straight down. My thighs and my knees are forward of my body, all right? About a 90 degree angle to my torso. And then I've got just maybe a little bit less than a 90 degree bend at my knees. So my toes are lining up with my sits bones. I'm gonna cinch in on my waist. That ensures that I'm kind of using and activating that transversus abdominal muscle. And I'm gonna keep my big toes together today, right, to start the clam. Let's take an inhale breath and an exhale just to lift that top knee and release. Have to adjust my band there, good. And two, and three, and four. We're going for that big range of motion. Five, and six, and seven, and eight, and nine, and just 10 today. Now we're gonna make a small change. I want you to flex your feet and feel like you're bringing your heels together. Flex feet, heels together. We keep going. One, and two, and three, and four. Keeping the range big still. Five, and six, and seven, and eight, and nine, and 10. Send your knees back so that your knees line up with your pelvis just a little bit more, and then prop yourselves up to your elbow. Press the elbow down into your mat. Create space between the top of the humerus and the shoulder girdle. Bring your top hand right to the top of your pelvis, right, so that you really are feeling the stability there. Take an inhale breath. Exhale, come up into a side plank position, right? Keep your feet flexed. Lift that top knee. Kick that leg forward. Kick your heel forward. Come back and squeeze. Two. Really keep this side of the rib cage lifted. And squeeze. Lift. Kick. Come back in. And squeeze. Lift. Kick. In. Squeeze. Keep your head in line with your spine. Lift. Kick. In, squeeze. Three more. Two more. Keep working that side of the body. One more. Good. And in, guys. Set the hip down. Come all the way back down. Fold your knees in and just release that hip. Just a short series today. Not too bad. We just really want to work those external rotators and glute and internal rotators. So glute meat as well. Let's come on to our other side. Good, line up our spines. Send those knees forward, toes underneath the sits bones. Activate transversus abdominis, bring your big toes together. Here we go, we're inhaling and exhaling to lift. One, and two, and three, and four, five, and six, and seven. Let's go, eight, and nine, and 10. Knees together, flex the feet, heels together. Here we go. One, and two. I feel this at a new level when I flex my feet. Three, and four. A few of you responded that you felt that as well. Good, four more, and three more, and two more. And one more. Send those knees back so they're more in line with the pelvis. Come up to your elbow, right? We press down to create space. Hand to the top of the hip, up into a side plank position. Keep those feet flexed today. Lift that top thigh, kick your heel forward, in and squeeze. Lift forward, in, squeeze. Lift forward, in, squeeze. Just a couple more. Keep creating space, lift, kick, in, squeeze, lift, kick, in. Let's do four more, we can do this. Three, more, two, more, last one. Come all the way down, guys, just rest on your elbow. Good, fold those knees in. A little release to the hip. Excellent, guys. Okay, come on up. Release your legs out of that loop band. Okay? Now let's go into a little
elbow plank exercise, right? So we're gonna go into elbow plank. Let me show this one just really quickly. We're not gonna do a lot of sets of it, just a few. I just think planking is such a good idea right now for all of us. So either clasped hands or interlaced fingers, whatever feels more comfortable to you. We go into plank and we're reaching our heels away from the crown of our heads to create that nice clear line, a little bit of scapular protraction, belly button muscles. So lifted, we're gonna lift our right leg and kick for 10. Left leg, kick for 10, right? Rock back and forth for a slow count of 10, hold for 10, and then we're gonna come out of it. I think we can all do that, guys. Just get that plank work in. If you'd like to come into full military push-up press, absolutely, you can do that. Your choice today. All right, guys, here we go. Let's get into it. This is gonna send us into plank for about a minute, and we like that. Elbow plank, belly button's lifted. Scapular protraction. Lift that right leg, one. Again, two, and three. Just the right leg, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Just the left, one, two. Hold those bodies, three, four. Think about where your head is, five, six. Abdominals, seven, eight, nine, 10, rocking back and forth. One, two, three, four. Think about the position. Five, six, seven. Squeeze those glutes. Eight, nine, 10. Isometrical. Keep breathing. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. We can come out of it, guys. Directly into child's pose. Big toes together, knees separated. Breathe deeply, just a little bit of spinal release. Forehead's nice and heavy on your mat. Big deep breaths. And then tailbone under. Slowly roll and stack your spines. Good, come on up, guys, face your screens. Come back to your neutral sitting position. All right, I think we got all the major muscle groups. We got our abs firing, we got our glutes, we got our hamstrings. We involved the upper body. We really got our obliques going today. I think we're ready to go on. All right, everybody. We're gonna finish up just with a little short stretch today. So just get into your most comfortable neutral position. We've talked about different ways to make that more comfortable for our bodies. You might wanna be sitting on a little cushion right now to start, or have your legs extended out in front, all right? Just gonna have everyone bring their hands to their thighs or their knees, whatever your sitting position is. Take a couple of nice deep diaphragmatic belly breaths. You can close your eyes if you'd like to. Take a nice big inhale breath through your nose. Really send the air down deep into the base of your lungs and feel those belly muscles expand and open with your breath. Let's hold that just for a moment at the top. And then shh, kind of making that shushing sound through your teeth to press the air out, feel the belly deflate and feel the abdominal wall flatten. Let's take that one more time. Nice big inhale breath. Really let the abdominal muscles release and open with your air. And then feel that release, feel that belly press all the way in. Go ahead and open your eyes. Take another inhale breath, send your head over to the right. And then exhale, slowly send the neck and head all the way around. And we'll take that once again. Releasing that stuck stress and that accumulated tension, adding the shoulders. Right, that stuck stress can make its way into the shoulder girdle as well. Taking the upper back around one more time. And then finally deepening it into the waist. Just circling the rib cage, easing the tension out of the spinal muscles and the rib cage. Let's send it around one more time. And then flex the spine forward And roll and stack it back up to neutral. We'll go in the opposite direction and head heavy over to the left this time. And as I always say, don't try to push anything. Roll gently over those hard spots. Don't force them. Adding our shoulders. Adding the waist. Circling the ribcage one more time. Before we flex the spine forward. And roll and stack it right back up. Let's take our head over to the right one more time. Some of you found this particular stretch. Here we go. A little bit intense last week. If you did, just modify it slightly. Just maybe not quite as much distance between the earlobe and the heel of the hand. But if it worked for you, go for it. We're just kind of breathing into the stretch right now. And I agree, this one can be intense. And then I'm just going to flex and extend the wrist a couple times. And then I'm going to circle it towards the wall behind me. And come forward just a couple of times. This is where it can get really intense. And then just flex the heel of the hand away. And come up. And probably what you're feeling is that big release of circulation down that side, that tight side of the body. We'll take it to the other side. And reach the heel of the hand away. Just begin to start feeling that stretch, the opening of those tight trapezius muscles. And then once again, we flex and extend and flex and extend and circle towards the back and circle forward. And then just press it away one more time. And come up and just feel that release. Wow, I know that got me today too. Wrap your arms around yourselves. Give yourselves a big hug. Really flex the upper back forward. And then release. Pull those elbows behind you and come into a little bit of thoracic extension or upper back extension. Now cross the opposite arm in front. And press those elbows back. Really try to open up the chest here. And then we open up the upper back. And we open up the chest. And once again, upper back. And chest. Good. Reach that right hand right towards your screen and really rotate your spine. And then reach those fingertips way up. And then rotate your spine in the opposite direction as you reach that hand behind you. And then drag the top of your hand and your wrist just right along your neck. We'll take that again. Reaching. Feeling that rotation, feeling that big stretch up, stretch through the upper arm, the armpit, and then rotate to the back and drag the wrist through. Let's go to the opposite side. Reach your left hand, feel that rotation, really long, and then up, and then spiral back. And we'll take that again, reaching. Good guys, and come through. Let's go right away into a child's pose position. Bring your big toes together. Open your knees into a narrow V. Just rest your belly right down on your thighs and reach your fingertips as far away from your tailbone as you possibly can. Forehead resting on your mat. Just feel that nice stretch through the spinal muscles, through the muscles of the shoulder girdle. Okay, and then I'm gonna have you slide your left hand in towards your left shoulder. And I'm gonna have you reach your right fingertips just a little further, so I'm kinda just creepy crawling them out there. And then I'm gonna walk my right hand over to my left side as far as I can until I get a really nice stretch. I'm feeling it all the way from my latissimus muscles all the way down to my obliques on that side. Just kinda breathe into that. And then come forward. And we're gonna switch sides. You're gonna slide your right hand to your right shoulder. Extend your left arm.
kind of creepy crawl it just a little bit longer until you start to feel that nice stretch. And then start to walk that left hand over towards the right side of your bend. And feel that, ooh, that nice stretch. Goes all the way into that QL. And then bring it back. And then slide both hands into your shoulders. We're gonna walk out into our quadruped position, guys. I don't wanna be too repetitive with these stretches, but I think some of these are just the right stretches for where we are right now in our lives. Heels of the hands are underneath the shoulders, knees right underneath my hip joints. We're gonna go into cat and cow. Take an inhale breath to prepare. As you exhale, really draw your belly button up through your spine, right up to the ceiling. Drop the tailbone and the sits bones under and drop the crown of your head. Now today we're gonna inhale. We're gonna go into the opposite position, dropping the belly button, lifting the tailbone, the sits bones, and the crown of the head slightly. And then we're gonna go back into our exhale. And back into our inhale. And once again, exhale. And inhale. One more time in each direction. Exhaling, breathing it out. And breathing it in. Let's come back to neutral and go into our hip rolls, guys. So walk those hands out away from your shoulders, just a little bit, they're a little bit forward of you, right? And we're gonna come forward and then roll the hip towards your screen and then really stick your tailbone and sits bones out as you go to the back. And then around. Take a couple more, two. Good, make those circles nice and big. Really try to release those hips. Three. Very lengthened spine. And four. And then let's go right away into the opposite direction. So now I'm just pressing my hip away from my screen, sending my tailbone and sits bones back. Hip comes towards my screen. And up. And we'll go two. And three. And one more. Just to really open those hips. Good, guys. Walk your hands back to your quadruped. Tuck your toes underneath and just press yourself back into your down dog position. Really lifting up the sits bones, lifting up the tailbone. Let's work into those hips a little bit. Small bend to that right knee. We'll send that right sit bone just a little bit higher. And then left. Really let your chest sink through your arm position. Right and left. Come back to those two stretched legs. Kind of sink just a little bit further. And I'm going to have you press into the sole of your left foot. Right? And extend that right leg up towards the ceiling. Give it that nice little stretch. And then snake it through. And go into our runner's stretch. Okay, so just sending that knee back. Make sure that this knee, right, guys, stays on this side of your toes. You don't want to overextend that knee forward. And just let those hips sink. Take a couple of nice deep breaths. Option to send those arms up and extend the chest towards the ceiling if you'd like to deepen that stretch just a little bit. And then come back and let's release into our pigeon pose. Okay, so right into pigeon pose. We've talked about the positioning of the front leg. We've talked about the positioning of the back leg. Just squaring off those shoulders and hips as much as you can. Option to fold forward. You don't need to, just an option. Intensify that stretch a little bit. And then if you chose to come forward, come all the way back up. Okay, we're gonna go into our stacked leg pose, right? So I'm gonna have my right leg underneath, my left leg on top today to start. Okay, and as again, as I always say, when I look down at my shins, they are stacked one right on top of the other. It's the best way to maximize this stretch. My feet are flexed. Option to walk the body forward if you'd like to, increasing the stretch. If you chose to walk the body forward, go ahead and walk it back up. Good, stacked knee pose. Top knee right over the bottom knee. Okay, now my knees are stacked. And remember for this one, important to maximize it, that your shins are actually parallel to the edge of the mat in front of you. So your heels are not, in other words, pulled in towards your hips. Okay. And let's take a nice reach.
back up. Now you can bring that bottom heel in towards your hip. Place the top foot just kind of flat on the mat. Give yourself just a little bit of spinal rotation. Nice deep breaths. Good, and unwind your position. Let's go back into our quadruped on this side. And curl those toes under. And then once again, press into that down dog position or pyramid position. See if you can get your tailbone sits bones just a little higher this time. And drop the belly and the chest through the arm position just a little bit more. Small bend to that left knee. Send that left sit bone right up to the ceiling. And then switch. And then left. And then right. And just come back to those stretched legs. Feel that nice stretch. Press down through your right foot and extend that left leg up. And then snake it through and right into your runner stretch. Letting those hips sink down. Square shoulders, square hip bones. Option to reach the fingertips towards the ceiling. And send the chest up towards the ceiling. Support the back of the head. Getting that nice psoas stretch. And come back up, bring the hands back to the knee. Good, just continue to feel that stretch. All right, we'll bring the hands to our mat and go into a pigeon pose. Squaring off the shoulders, squaring off the hips, lengthening that back leg. Walking forward if you'd like to. Feel the deepening of that stretch. It can be a little intense. But most of our hips are pretty tight right now. You guys know that, I know. And walk back up. Right, just take a moment. And then come all the way around. Okay, so now our left leg's gonna be on the bottom. And our right leg will be on top for our stacked leg pose. Ooh, I feel this more today. Wow, that's kind of eye-popping. What I call the wasabi moment. I'm getting a little wasabi on that hip. Walk forward if you would like to. And if you chose to walk forward, walk back up. And cross that top knee over the bottom knee as we go into stacked knee pose. Good, just really trying to feel those sits bones. And then let's reach. And away. And once again. Heel in towards your hip, top foot flat on your mat, a little bit of spinal rotation, deep breaths, and unwind. Okay, if you've got your resistance band or your flex band, go ahead and grab that. Okay. Let's put the arch of the right foot into your band, and go ahead and roll all the way onto your back. Right, let's try to lengthen that left leg if we can. Okay. I like to wrap my band around my hand to give myself a little bit of extra grip. That's just an option. You don't need to do that. Okay, we did this one last time. Right now, all I'm doing is really flexing my foot and extending my heel upwards towards the ceiling as I press down through the back of the same hip, that hip on the same side. All right, so I go down through the hip and up through the heel to create a little bit of opposition. Okay, good. All right, now I'm gonna have you bring both ends of your band into your right hand. And today, you can have a flex foot or a pointed toe, doesn't matter. Go ahead and just reach that, let it fall open to the side. A good counterbalance to this one is reach your left hand out to the side like the letter T. Just feel that band kind of guide your leg into a little bit of an adductor stretch. And then bring it back up and transfer both ends now into your left hand and reach your right arm out to the side, palm facing down. We did this one last time. You're just gonna gently cross that leg over the midline of the body and bring it straight back up. For the first couple, I'd really like you to feel the back of that right hip press down through your mat. We'll take a bigger release in just a little moment here. And up. Okay, now here we go. I'm gonna bring the leg way across the midline of the body. Let my right hip roll up and away from the mat and just feel that release right across the hip. Breathe into it. And bring it on up. And okay, one end in each hand now. All I'm gonna do is bicycle my left foot up into the band before I release my right foot out, so it makes it much easier, okay? So we'll call this the hip to heel stretch. So I'm pushing the back of my left hip down and I'm really reaching my left heel up. Almost getting a little fuzzy sensation through the back of my leg. Okay, good, breathing into it once again. Okay, bring both ends into your left hand, reach that right arm out to the side, palm facing down. And just let that leg fall open. That right arm is gonna help kind of counterbalance that side of the body. Kind of like what we talk about when we're talking about standing leg stability. And then just float it up and change hands. I'm moving both ends into my right hand now. Send my left arm out to the side, palm facing down. And I start just with a small crossing over the midline because I really wanna keep that left hip down for the first two. And then release it back up. And then another small cross. And up. Okay, now I'm gonna let that hip roll off my mat. And I'm just gonna let gravity take it to where it needs to go. A couple of nice deep breaths into this one. This is another one that can be pretty intense. And then send it straight back up. Good, guys. Release your foot out of your band. Just take your band off to the side. Hug your knees in towards your chest, towards your torso. And just let the torso rock side to side a couple of times. And then release the arms out to the side, palms facing down, just slightly lower than your shoulders. And take your legs towards your screen. And when they float to the floor, look away from your screen. Breathing into that nice spinal rotation. And then look, stare straight up at your ceiling. Bring your legs through the center and let them float away from your screen as you turn your head to face your screen. Breathing into that stretch. Should feel good. Good, guys. Keep your head where it is, face your screen, just bring your legs back up, let them float all the way towards your screen and bring that back hand over, and we're all just gonna kind of roll on up. Just sit in your neutral position facing your screen. Take just a couple of shoulder rolls, and just in case any tension accumulated during our quadruped or our down dog. Good, a little head roll. And to the other side. And come on up. All right, everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you for hanging in there with me. I'm really enjoying making these for you. And I hope you guys just continue to stay safe, stay well, and know that I love you all. Till next time.